In this video, we're going to look how to test the assumptions of a linear regression using SPSS. As a recap, the assumptions of a linear regression are that the dependent and independent variables have a linear relationship. If doing a multiple linear regression, you will also need to check that the independent variables do not correlate too strongly with each other, that the residuals follow a normal distribution, that the residuals have equal variances, and finally, that there are no outliers. The dataset we are going to be using for this tutorial is based on the birth weight of newborn babies. Our dependent variable will always be the birth weight of babies, and we will use multiple different independent variables, which are all scale variables, such as the mother's age and height. Please open the data file Birth Weight Reduced on SPSS to follow along, and refer back to the Regression SPSS Handbook for more detail. The first assumption we are going to check is testing whether there is a linear relationship between the independent variables and dependent variable. This has to be done for each independent variable separately. A scatter graph is a useful way to visualize this. For this example, we are going to use the weight of the babies as our dependent variable and gestational age as our independent variable. See the video in the next slide for how to run a scatter graph in SPSS. A scatter plot on SPSS. Firstly, you go to the Graphs tab at the top, then down to Legacy Dialogues, and then the Scatter and Dot button. From here, you'll click Simple Scatter and then press Define. For this example, we're going to use our dependent variable, which is weight of the baby, as our y-axis, and one of the independent variables, so for example, gestational age, as the x-axis. Once you've defined these two variables, you'll click OK. This will produce a scatter plot for you. To get the line of best fit, you'll double click on the graph, which will open the chart editor tab. From here, you'll go up to elements and then fit line at total. This will produce the line of best fit and also your R squared value. So SPSS will produce this scatter plot for you. So as you can see from the graph, the data does appear to have a linear relationship and also a positive one, which you can tell from the direction of the points. But one thing we can use to check whether there is a linear relationship is whether the R squared value is above 0.3. Our R squared value here is 0.499. So this indicates that there is a linear relationship between the weight of the babies and gestational age. The majority of the remaining assumptions can be tested during the setup of the regression itself. For this regression, we are going to use the baby's birth weight as the dependent variable, and gestational age, length of baby, maternal height, and father's age as the independent variables. To see how to run a multiple linear regression on SPSS, watch the video in the next slide. To run a regression in SPSS, firstly you go to Analyze at the top, down to Regression, and then click Linear Regression. For this example, we're going to use our dependent variable, which is birth weight, in the dependent box, and then other scale variables for the independent variables. So for example, gestational age, length of baby, maternal height, father's height, and father's age. We leave the method as the default enter. Then you click on statistics, and here we want to make sure that model fit is ticked, R squared changed, descriptive statistics, part and partial correlations, estimates, and collinearity diagnosis. Then we click on plots, and here we click on normal probability plot and move the Z resid scores, which are standardized residuals, to the Y axis, and our Z-PRED scores, which are the standardized predictor scores, to the x-axis. And then you click continue. And finally, we click save. And then for residuals, you want to click unstandardized. And for distances, you want to click cooks. You press continue, and then your regression is ready to run. So you click OK. This will produce all of the SPSS output that you need to check for the assumptions and also how to write it up. But the boxes we'll be focusing on firstly are the correlations. This will help us with the whether the dependent and independent variable have a linear relationship, and also to see whether the independent variables correlate too strongly with each other. We will also look at the residual statistics, and this will be to check for any outliers. And then finally, our charts at the bottom. The PP plot will be used to check for whether the data is normally distributed or not. And the scatter plot will be used to look for equality of variances.
If you have a lot of independent variables, making a scatter graph with each independent variable and the dependent variable to check for a linear relationship might be too time consuming. So another thing you can do is look at the correlations table. So what you want to look at is this first column here, which will show you the correlations for the weight of the baby at birth, which is our dependent variable, with all the independent variables here, including height of father, father's age, maternal height, length of baby, and gestational age. And here, this top column shows you the Pearson's correlation statistics. You want to check to see whether any of these values are below 0.3. If they are, you may want to remove them from the dataset or transform them. As you can see here, all of our independent variables have a linear relationship with the dependent variable, except for father's age and height of father, as these statistics are below 0.3. You can also use the same correlations box to check for assumption 2, that is, whether the independent variables correlate too strongly with each other. So again, you would look across at the Pearson's correlation row and at all the different correlations. So for example, length of baby and gestational age is 0.651. You want to see whether any of these values are above 0.7. If they are, this would suggest that they are too highly correlated and one would need to be removed. However, as you can see here, none of our values exceed 0.7, so our regression is fine to run as it is. The next assumption we want to test for is for a normal distribution. Remember, when testing for a normal distribution, the null hypothesis assumes that the data are normally distributed. Therefore, a significant p-value means that the data is not normally distributed. The two most commonly used tests are the KS test and the SW test. To see how to run these tests of normality on SPSS, watch the video on the next slide.
To check whether your data is normally distributed, you need to go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then Explore. Here you want to put your unstandardized residuals, RES1, into the dependent list. Then you want to click Plot, untick Stem and Leaf, but tick Histogram and Normality Plots with Tests, and then click OK. Firstly, this will produce a histogram, which will show you whether the data is normally distributed by looking for a bell-shaped curve. And then next, it will produce QQ plots, which you can also use to see whether the data is normally distributed.
The first thing you want to look at when you've run your test of normality is the test of normality output. So here you can see the results of the KS and SW tests. Both of the p-values are not significant. So this suggests that our data is normally distributed. You can also look for normal distribution visually. For example, the histogram shows a bell-shaped curve, which again suggests that the data is normally distributed. Second, you can look at the QQ plot. If the data is normally distributed, the points of the graph should align with the diagonal line, as they do here. So again, this suggests that the data is normally distributed. And finally, we can look at the PP plot. Again, if the data closely follow the diagonal line, this suggests that the data does have a linear relationship and is normally distributed. As you can see here, the data falls closely to the diagonal line. The next assumption is testing equality of variance. This scatter plot shows the regression standardized residuals on the y-axis and the regression standardized predicted values on the x-axis. This helps us to check whether there is equality of variance between the residuals. If some of the data were tight at one end but wide at the other, like a triangle, this would suggest that the variance is not equal enough. In this example, the data points are mostly clustered in the centre and do not look like a triangular pattern, so there appears to be equal variance. And finally, we want to check for any outliers. For this, you use the residuals statistics table and you'll look for the Cook's distance value. The Cook's distance value should not exceed 1. This is the case in our results below, where the minimum value is 0 and the maximum value is 0.278. If there are outliers in the data, you may want to remove them or transform them, but you must have a good reason for doing so.